Welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we are looking to this woven style engagement ring design. I'm going to show you how to model the metal work here. Are you ready? Let's get started. That's starting with the stone in 6mm round. And if you want to know how to make this stone, I will have a video up here on the right top corner to show you how to model the stone. So we have the stone in 6mm. We want to come into the front view and draw a circle. And for the demonstration, I'm just going to set it as a 16mm. And I'm going to come into the top view and kind of draw my design on it. Let's go ahead to draw a curve. And it's kind of coming over here, wrapping around this stone and end it up here. Make sure this is longer than your ring. And you can go ahead to edit into the shape that you like. I would like to have them a little bit unsymmetrical. So maybe one side I want it to be more puffier and the other side is narrower, something like that. The second thing I wanted to draw maybe is a circle, something look like this. And I want to move it more close to offset a little bit. And that's using the command split. And we want to split with the point, one from here, the other one from here. So then that will be hiding behind this curve. That's coming into the front view. And we want to making a copy. On this copy, I want this go a little bit higher. So this is showing where the ring shank is, and this is showing how high is this piece is going to be. Now we are going to creating a surface. We are going to create a curve on two views, and we want to create this one and this one. I'm going to mark it into the red color. The second curve that I'm going to have, I need to have that half round looking things going in a little bit higher than what I have on this one. So I'm going to draw a straight line on my right view and come back to my perspective. I'm going to use the curve front two view again, this one and this one. Let me turn it into the red color, is easier for you to see. And since we don't need the red one for the bottom, I'm going to trim off the one on the bottom. Okay, so let's go ahead to delete this one and hiding the curve that we don't need it. And since we have a lot of a point right there, so let's go ahead to rebuild this guy and this guy for about 12 point and click OK. So it's easier for us to do the editing. One thing I wanted to make sure is this two will go a little bit lower, so when I rotate it to the other side, it will look one on the top of the other. So we're gonna have this one go a little bit lower. And also on this curve over here, apparently it is higher than our center stone, and so it will take away the attention from our center stone. So I'm going to move them down a little bit lower. So let me turn it into the green color. So now if we're looking at this, this green is on top of the red on this spot. And when they turn it over, this green is under the red. So this should work. But let's give it a try and see how that works. And we are going to pipe it in 0.8 for the radius on that one and 0.8 on this one. Okay, and see if that is working for you, and if you like the size or if you want to change or things like that. We also wanted to pick up both of them. And let's go ahead to rotate, make sure copy equal yes, and rotate 180 degree and see what we have is like this. And so you can kind of see if you go up and down and everything going to the way that you like. Now I noticed that this might be too long right here, so we might need to trim this one a little bit shorter. We don't want it to stick it out that much. This is coming in inside okay, but it may be a little bit too long on that end as well, so we might need to trim a little bit on both sides. This curve alright over here, I would like it to be more straight, so that way it will be not wiggly over there. So we kind of look at it and do the adjustment we need to do. So I'm going to pick up this curve, maybe moving this up a little bit, this down a little bit, so they are straighter. Or you can select those points right here and using the command set point. And we want to align with the Y over here and moving straight down like that. And we may want to do the same thing on this side and straight down like this. Okay, so another thing we were talking earlier, maybe this is too long. Want to remove a couple point and moving the point right here about like this. Now, if you don't like the shape, and you can go ahead to adjust it, maybe it's come out too much. So you can do your own design and adjust to the way that you like it. All right, so once we have this done, I would like to creating the cross section. I usually like to have a shank. It's about 1.5 millimeter thick. And for this one, I'm going to set it up for 1.6 millimeter. And to make it look nicer, let's go ahead to using the art tools, snapping into near over here and here. And that's snapping into right in the middle of the edge, and we can use that to trim this section and this section. Let's go ahead to join it and make it look nicer by giving a corner fillet, maybe 0.2 millimeter, so they will look nicer over there. Okay, so with that, let's go ahead to mirror to the other side for something like this, and let's do a test over here. We are going to using the sweep one rail, and this is the rail cross section here and here, and we want to make sure that they're facing the same direction and align with it. So I usually like to align with the inside of the ring shank, and we will get something like this. I also like to do is to record a history so we can do the real-time changing if it is needed. All right, apparently, if I need to have another one fly over, this apparently is a little bit too tall. So what I like to do is pick up the curve that we have and do the 1D scale on the curve, because I recorded a history already. So we could do that, something like this. And this surface should follow. I also try not to get in too much inside of my ring shank, even though I'm going to trim it later, but I do not want them to be losing the shape too much. So I kind of wanted to do something like that. Okay, so this is just a test, and we probably need to redo it later on, but just for us to do the test right here. I also may want to moving this two curve a little bit, something like that. Okay, so that is the first one. The second one is the green color over here. So we want to use the same profile. I'm going to making a copy from this point to this point. And I also wanted to having this rotated like that and rotated like that. The ideal position is always for your cross section is facing the same direction of your rail is going to be. So something like this for this rail. Okay, we also need to make another copy. So I'm going to making a copy from this point to this point, and also kind of moving like that. All right, let's take a look on the perspective view and turning into the green color. So we will have this one. I would like them to sit it on top of it. So going to move from the midpoint to the top, something like this. And we also need to move this one to the top here. All right, so let's give it a try. We wanted to do the sweep one rail. This is rail cross section, and also the another cross section here, and make sure you want to record a history moving the seam in the middle on the bottom. So we get something like this. Okay, so this one looked like it go on the top, but it doesn't go lower. So this one actually need to move lower in order to get some sort of a cross like this. And also notice that maybe this is too coming out too much. So I want to pick up the red curve and pick up the control point. We want to move it down a little bit more. I also noticed that this surface right here is going in this direction, tilted in. I do like to have the surface on this point facing up, so that way I will have a better stone setting. So I'm going to making another copy from here to the cauldron, and that's moving around. Make sure the direction is correct. So once we have it, we want to go ahead to do another sweep one rail. Record a history again. We want to go from here to here to here, and make sure they are facing the same direction and align with the same place. Alright, and then you can keep tweaking but make sure that you are working with the curve. We can also turn on the wireframe. It's easier for us to see the point right now. Make sure you are working with the curve, not the surface, because you have a history recorded, so you might want to work something more like this. And also want to turn on the control point on this one. Maybe this needs to coming out a little bit more to be something like this. And I do not want to have my top is on top of this line, so maybe I need to moving out even more. Alright, so you keep working on it until you find something that you like. Now if we look at this front of the ring, notice that it doesn't follow our ring shank anymore, and we need to have the inside is round. So right in the middle, I actually need to make them a little bit thicker. So what I like to do is I want to extract the ISO curve, and we want to pick up this surface. Let's do a toggle, so it will go in this direction, and we want to mark it somewhere right in the middle, something like that. Okay, so now we can delete this one completely. For this curve right here, I'm going to rework on them to make them a little bit taller. So I'm going to turn on the control point, and let's go ahead to select the point here. All right, so it will go something like this. And basically, I'm going to move it down a little bit. So make sure they are long enough. If we look at the front view, make sure that they are passing this ring shank over there. So then we will have enough room to trim it. Let's do another sweep. Sweep one rail. You got rail one, cross, cross, and cross. And make sure you want to align to the middle right there. And then we want to align right here. Okay, so once we have it, we are going to make sure you record a history, and we'll get something like this. As you can see, it's passing the line right in the middle, and let's click OK. Alright, so then we have this thickness, and this one will coming inside, and make sure you don't have this sticky out. So I'm going to actually come into my top view, talking a little bit, so it's the ending is not sticking out over there. Alright, so now we have this. Let's do another test. We wanted to rotate it and make sure copy equal yes, and we want to go from here to here. So you will have something like this. So we're gonna leave it here temporary like that. Let's go ahead to making the C for the center stone. I'm simply going to make a prong set, and the prong will look something like this. And let's go ahead to pipe it. For diameter, it's about 1.2 millimeter. And make sure I want to move it out. We do not want to cutting into the prong too much. The prong will be very weak. Let's go ahead to do the polar array. And we want a 4 of them for 360 degree, and then we'll get something like this. So let me mark them into the blue color. Alright, so that's where the prong is. And we also need to make a bezel underneath it. So at my front view, I'm going to disable my all snap and draw a bezel roughly, again, want to be longer and roughly like this. Want to tilt it a little bit, moving in a little bit. All right, so with that, let's go ahead to do the revolve from zero. And you will do 360 degree, and then you will have the understone bezel. Turn them in blue color. So this is what we have. With this one, if you feel like you don't want to have a prong going this direction, you may want to tilt it them to fitting into other direction, or sometimes you can fitting into the gap that you have there. It depends on how you like your design to be. And now I notice that this curve, the ending is kind of a stopping over there, so I might need to move this curve inside a little bit more and maybe tilt it a little bit more like this. Or after moving that one, if that one talking too much, I may want to pick up my curve original one and turn on the control point, and this time we want to edit the point coming out a little bit. So you can keep editing since you have the record history, so you can keep editing if you want to. So maybe I want this one coming out a little bit like this as well. And the very final one, let's go ahead to moving a little bit. Now we have this one. I need to make the bottom of the ring shank, so I'm going to make a copy from the midpoint, from the midpoint here to the quadrant over there, and let's go ahead to rotate it. Make sure copy is equal no. We just need to rotate this guy for 90 degrees over here. Okay, so we're gonna do some sweeping. We're gonna sweep. This is the rail. We're gonna go from this curve to this curve to this curve. And again, I want to align to inside of a ring shank and facing the same direction. So we get something like this. And all we need to do is mirror to the other side. So we will have the metal work. Let's go ahead to join this one and this one, and the same with this one. And for the one on the top, I would like to cap them so they all become solid. All we have left is the B setting, and I do have a few video right here showing you how to do the B setting. You can click on this. You can click on those video and the playlist to see how the B setting is working. For the members, please watch the second part of the video. I will show you how I arrange those B setting in there. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. If you want to see more of my trick and tips, please sign up the membership program. It is a small monthly fee, but you are going to see a lot more member-only video. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.